terrified to have to go and dig up Jason. Some folks have a strange idea of entertainment.
What's up, everybody? How's everybody doing today? We're going to be continuing our Friday the 13th movie marathon. And today we got Friday the 13th, part 6, Jason Lives. Okay, so after that disaster of a movie, Part 5, A New Beginning, I was really worried about where this franchise was going, but holy fuck, Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives was an awesome fucking movie. It's films like this that remind me of why I'm such a Friday the 13th fan. This is the first Friday the 13th movie where the director actually focuses more on cinematography. The cinematic shots in this movie were badass. I mean, which other Jason movie do you know where they flip a fucking RV? So Tommy Jarvis is back for the third straight time, acted by Tom Matthews. He and his buddy escape from the loony bin to dig up Jason's dead body and pretty much destroy it. Tommy killed Jason at the end of part 4, but since then he's had some real psychological issues with Jason. So they dig up Jason and Tommy starts stabbing Jason's dead body with a long metal rod, but a strike of lightning comes down and pretty much shocks Mr. Jason back to life. Now Jason is portrayed by the actor CJ Grahm, and might I add, this is the first Friday the 13th movie where Jason isn't human. Up until this point, Jason had like human skin behind the mask. This is the start of the resurrected zombie Jason that we get from here on out. So Jason's alive and on the loose. Tommy runs to the local sheriff's office where we're introduced to our final girl, Megan, who's the sheriff's daughter.
Jason who?
Megan, stay away from him. He's dangerous.
Not dangerous. Jason is out there. He's looking for me. He's probably headed back to the camp.
I told you to shut up.
You mean the Jason of Camp Blood?
Yes.
No.
Apparently, they changed the name Crystal Lake to Forest Green so people wouldn't be reminded of Jason and what he did here, but boy are their memories about to be jogged. Pretty much, Jason's trying to track down Tommy and kill his ass, but nobody will believe Tommy about Jason except for the sheriff's daughter, Megan, who forms a little relationship with Tommy. Now, two things I found odd about this movie is I don't think we hear the famous at any point in this movie. Also, there's no nudity here. This is the first Friday the 13th movie that doesn't have any nudity. There's a sex scene, but they don't show anything. Now, the kills in this movie were fucking awesome. However, at this point in time, they really toned down the amount of blood and gore that we get, but nonetheless, the kills are great. A girl gets her head smashed into an aluminum wall inside that RV. Gravedigger gets stabbed in the throat with broken glass from his pint of vodka.
What a way to go, huh?
Did you guys notice the blood dripping out of the top of the bottle? Now, I was really rooting for the sheriff in this movie. He damn near made it all the way to the end, but Jason folds this motherfucker in half. So Jason kills off all- no wait, I like this kill too. So Jason kills off all the camp counselors, he lets the children live, but he scares the piss out of them. Tommy lures Jason into Crystal Lake. He plans to sink Jason to the bottom of the lake with a huge rock and some chains. Now back to the good cinematography, this final act looks fucking awesome. I don't know, just with like the fire on the water, it just looks badass. So Tommy finally sinks Jason to the bottom of Crystal Lake, and a direct quote from Tommy, Jason is finally home. This was an all-around fun Friday the 13th movie. My two favorite things, first of all, without a doubt, was the 1980s cinematic style that this movie was filmed in. I mean, even the music soundtrack kept the fire burning here. Alice Cooper was huge in the 1980s. His song Teenage Frankenstein can be heard playing on the radio inside that RV. And at the end of the movie, when the credits start rolling, they play his song He's Back, The Man Behind the Mask. And secondly, the pacing. The pacing of this movie was really good. There really wasn't any boring spots in this movie. One thing I noticed about this franchise is that there's some really boring segments in 3, 4, and 5, but not here. The pacing is really good. I like how the camera kind of follows Jason as he makes his way to Crystal Lake to find and kill Tommy. This was the type of movie I would have loved to have taken a sweet and sexy date to go see when it came out in theaters, but I wasn't born for another two more years. Oh, what did you think of Jason's look in this movie? He wore yellow gloves and had like a little tool belt to keep his murder paraphernalia close. A lot of fans didn't approve of Jason's look in this movie, but it didn't bother me. You can, however, tell the difference between this Jason and the Jason from part 3 and 4. Jason no longer has his natural skin color. He looks tall and skinny here. He's definitely not as scary as Richard Brooker's portrayal of Jason from part 3, but I didn't mind because of how entertaining and fun this movie was. Now, I'm sure that I'm speaking way too soon here, but I think that this might be my favorite Friday the 13th movie. And I still got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, I still got 8 films to go if you include the 2009 remake, which I definitely think I'm gonna make that a part of this marathon. I give Friday the 13th part 6 Jason Lives a decent 4 out of 5, but Justin, if you love this movie so much, why not give it a perfect 5 out of 5 rating? Well, to answer that, yes, I did love Jason Lives, but the movie wasn't perfect. I already told you about the two things that I found odd about this movie. In fact, those things aren't even big enough things to take away a whole rating point, but okay, here it is. I got 4 letters for you. MPAA. The MPAA is the association that does the whole rating system. They pretty much decide how much blood and gore gets to be in your movies, and they pretty much tone down all the kills in this movie. In fact, I feel like from here on out, every Friday the 13th movie is going to be watered down because of the MPAA. I don't know, I just feel like we're not going to get as much blood and gore as we got in the previous films, especially 3 and 4. 4 especially. Like, that final kill with Jason was insane. Like, those effects looked so real. The MPAA pretty much steps in and says, hey, that kill looks too real. You got to tone it down a little bit. So I feel like they're going to do that from here on out with all the Friday the 13th movies. But nonetheless, I still love this franchise. I definitely recommend seeing this movie, especially if you're thinking about becoming a classic horror fan. I loved Jason Lives. Up next, we got Friday the 13th, Part 7, New Blood. Do me a favor and hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it so you can receive notifications every time I upload a video. My name is Justin fucking Ray. You guys be safe. Stay tuned for more Friday the 13th movie reviews. I'm marathoning this whole entire franchise. While everybody's stuck inside with this whole coronavirus shit, I'm watching every single film, and I'm gonna decide which Friday the 13th movie was the very best one. You guys be safe, have a good day. I'll see you guys on this side or the other side. Peace, motherfuckers.